Hello, welcome to this new tutorial. Today we are going to see the just launched Claude Desktop Extensions. What is that? How to install it? And we may even code someone. Okay, so the extensions, also called DXT, that's the file format, are basically just like MCP, compressed MCP, you may say. And it's like an MCP installer, okay? And the idea is that you can install MCP servers to, for example, Cloud Desktop or Cloud Coder or even Cursor with just one click or two clicks in this case, just as you would install any other software. Because we know until now, if we are here in Cloud Desktop, if we wanted to install MCPs, we have to do it like from here, developer, and we have to modify the Cloud Desktop configuration JSON, yeah. And here had to pay to paste the different servers and all the commands. I don't know, is this going to load or not? I mean, it has never been a smooth process, isn't it? And oh God. Well, you may say it has never been really, really easy to do. And the idea is that everyone can install a server with just double clicking it. I'm so sorry, don't know when. This is one of the problems with the JSONs with, is something like this. We all know MCPs work like this. So you install it, you paste it. You go, for example, I don't know, to Smithry. And yeah, you just need to install, and for example this is the search one, and we could install it with a command or even paste in the JSON. Yeah, so for the extensions it's a little bit different. How is it? Well, we come here and we have in Cloud, you go to settings. Some computers may need to enable the developer tools. It's okay. And here we have a new tab called extensions, okay? So just if you don't see it, just update the Cloud. You can update Cloud Desktop here. And here we will see the extensions. There are some pre-built ones, like for example, Chrome for browser automation, file system notes. So we are going to see, for example, how to install that iMessage one. This one I got it from the official Anthropic DXT repo. You see only 30 forks. When you are watching this video, I guess will be a few more. Okay, so basically here it comes with some example ones. Okay, so I've just cloned this repo. We can just clone it. Okay, so we can clone it, and you can get, for example, the you have Hello World node, file manager, Python, and Chrome Apple script. Okay, so I have another one. I have the iMessage one, for example. You can see it here. Yeah. Okay, so I have basically, I have one. Basically, we have a folder with these two folders. Okay, so this is the iMessage one. It has the, you know, the structure of a normal standard MCP with the different that it needs a manifest. Yes, if it was a Chrome extension, for example, and the package JSON and even some icon. I mean, it's quite cool. And the key thing is that it includes, you know, it includes the dependencies. So you can see here the node modules that are, well, the node dependencies. So it is like, you may call it a self-contained MCP, okay? And this is the Ampeg DXT. Okay, how did I get that? Okay, so I, okay, we get here. Okay, and this is the installer. How did I get it? I'm just going to get rid of this. Okay, let me just get one Okay, so we have this. Okay, so this is the structure I have. You know, I have it from the official repo, and here I just run this. You can install DXT with Node with this command, and npm install global Anthropic AI / DXT, and then we can convert any MCP. Actually, we have even here the prompt. We can give it a try later. But basically, just need to run this thing. So basically, just getting an MCP, adding a manifest, and we can run the DXT pack, as you see here. Okay. You see? And it created a DXT. Okay, I think you will feel better in the, yeah. Okay, let's go open this. A ver, okay, so we have it here, as you can see. This is the iMessage one, okay? And this is the DXT we just created. So if we double click it, we have, yeah, you can double click and you see we have the extension that just comes here and is ready for install. It's much easier than MCP. It can be, you know, they actually say it's multi-platform. I don't really know. For example, this one is going to be run on Windows. I guess it will get it will get a little bit mature later. Okay, so we see here that just with install, okay, this is from the MCPs, has nothing to do with here, we have already installed it in one click. So that means that if we go to extensions, yeah, we have the fourth extension here. Okay, we could also install it like this in advanced settings. I mean, it reminds me a lot of Google Chrome extensions, because even the install unpacked or the, yeah, they are quite similar. Okay, so here we have in Claude, this is Claude Desktop main configuration folder, and here we have the extensions. Okay, so, well, this is the unpacked ones once they are installed. That means that each extension you install, you actually get access to the source code. That is quite a nice thing, and it's quite, I mean, it's common with Google Chrome extensions. So we could have also like install it. For example, let's say we want to install the notes one. I don't know. I'm going just to move it out from here. I mean, if we want to uninstall it, we just have to remove it from here. Okay, and I guess that if we if we run again this, yeah, we have to just, I mean, this, the new Macintosh is really so slow. I don't really know why. Okay, so here we have relaunch Cloud Desktop, and if we come here, yeah, we don't have the notes one. At least we don't have it installed. So we could also install it even if without creating the DXT installer. We can drag in a DXT here, but even if we don't have it, we can just install unpacked. And I guess that if we sorry about that. I'm sorry. Yeah, new tutorials, DXT extensions. If we choose like the notes one, for example, this one, we can install it without the DXT, just like that. And yeah, it would get installed. We can enable it here. And actually, I mean, it is just an MCP server. Here, even it writes which command it has and the tools and everything, and then I guess we can you can just use it from the from the extension here. As you can see, it is rendered just as any other MCP. For example, in this case, here we have them. For example, this is the nodes one, list nodes, get add node. Let's, for example, let's try it out. For example, node with create a node with, for example, let's get the prompt. This is the prompt for creating extensions. Let's try it out. Node with following. Let's try it out. This is DXT. DST. Okay, we got that. I will say yes, a note. I'm just going to write that because I have too many MCPs, so I mean, this way is, I mean, without it, I guess it would have worked anyway, but why not? Yeah, let's try it. I mean, it's a bit confusing, the fact that, I don't know, you guys, you have realized or not, but right now we have even three ways of installing MCPs. You can install it. Okay, this is the thing I was a bit afraid of. Okay, just use the notes. Okay, I didn't, this is following it itself. I'm so sorry. Yeah, I mean, I should have done that. I was a bit lazy. Yeah, with that, we can just try it. I was saying that we have, okay. This seems to be working. I mean, it's like any other MCP, you can say, okay. And it has gotten it right, okay. Okay, this is the key time because it needs control, okay. We are going to allow it, why not? And now I guess the nodes, I have never tried it really, but it's easy to guess. It will just open it. Okay, but anyway, I was saying that at this time we have even three kinds of installation processes for the MCPs. We have the one we said here, Cloud Settings Developer with the JSON here. We have the extensions, the ones that we have seen today, and we even have the they will merge them someday. Not really late, I guess sooner than later. We even have this, right? What is called integrations. So integrations is also a kind of MCP. I mean, integrations is only for the remote MCPs. So the idea is that you just get a remote MCP here. For example, I love Smithery, so all the Smithery ones we can get. For example, okay, sorry. Let's get, for example, one of my MCPs, good MCPs. The Vuda, the automated UE debugger. and we all know that we can install it, as we say, from JSON. This is the MCP we saw in settings, the other one, and we can install it also with this HTTP. Okay, we get it, you get the link, good. And this is the last kind of installation that is called an integration. Yeah, I think I already have it over here. Yeah, I have it over there, is this one. But basically, I mean, we can get rid of it, you see? And yeah, I mean, the integrations are quite nice. Okay, so we have these three kinds of MCP installation processes. Yeah, sometimes Cloud Desktop is just crazy. A ver. Late. This one is nice, you should give it a try for the many times, like when programming, some buttons are not working, and you know, we need this kind of debugging loop that it tests all the buttons and it fixes the code and tests again. I mean, it saves a lot of time. I really recommend it. Okay, so we were checking out the last kind of installation, the integrations one that I was saying is just for remote MCPs. Okay. Okay. So for example, this visual. Oh yeah. And you can install it. It won't allow me, I guess, because I removed it. And we just connect it, and actually we have it just like this. And we have it installed just like this. The only difference is that it loads the small image, okay? And we have it installed there. It needs to reload, and there is. Okay, so if we want to try the prompt for creating a DXT, we can give it a try. Let's try it on the next video. Okay, so thank you very much, and thank you for following my channel, and let's keep it up.